let's go over the basics of editing a podcast. In this video, we'll cover different effects and editing techniques that will help your podcast sound better. These editing techniques can be used in all audio editing softwares. In this tutorial, I'll be using Adobe Audition. You can also use free audio editing software like Audacity. All right, let's cover the basic techniques of normalization, noise reduction, compression, and equalization. First, let's talk about normalization. Normalization is pretty straightforward. It normalizes the audio to a defined loudness. So the loudest parts of the audio do not cross a certain defined point. This is different than compression because it adjusts both the loudest and quietest parts of the audio equally. Let's apply normalization to this clip. Click Effects, then Amplitude and Compression, then click Normalize. Normalize to defines the point where the loudest part of the audio will not cross. I like to apply normalization before and after effects like compression and equalization to always have a good starting point and ending point for my audio editing. I like to normalize to -6 decibels before an effect, then do an effect, and then renormalize to -6 decibels. Then, after all my editing is complete, I normalize to -3 decibels. This is my way of mastering my audio track to a good volume. Now let's talk about noise reduction. This can be helpful if you have unwanted noise in your audio. Most audio editing software has some form of noise reduction. Let's open the basic noise reduction effect here in Audition. Click Effects, then Noise Reduction / Restoration, then Denoise. At the top, there are presets for light noise reduction and heavy noise reduction. You can also use the slider at the bottom to apply a certain amount of the effect to the clip. You can also determine what frequency ranges you want the effect to be applied to. This is if the noise is only in the high, mid, or low frequencies. I like to click the Output Noise Only button. This lets me play the audio clip and only hear what the effect is deleting or removing from the audio. Then I adjust the amount and focusing, so it's only the noise that's being affected and not the voice. Then I unclick the output noise only and apply the effect. Another tip is to apply noise reduction before normalizing, EQ, and compression. This makes it so the effects won't be applying themselves to any type of noise. And if there's any residual noise at the end, then apply another light round of noise reduction to clean everything up. Now let's talk about compression. Compression is a way of taking the loudest and quietest parts of your audio and bringing them closer together. This is done by establishing a level where the compression effect will kick in, known as a threshold, and how much it will compress the louder parts beyond that set amount, making the louder parts closer to the quieter parts. This helps make everything easier to hear and understand. Let's apply compression to this clip. I'm going to go to my Effects tab, click on Amplitude and Compression, and then Single Band Compressor. Let's start at the top. Threshold is when you want the compressor to kick in. So if it's set to -12 decibels, then any audio that's louder than that level will be compressed and kept close to -12 decibels. Then there's ratio, which is how much it will compress the audio above the threshold. The larger the ratio, the more compression. I suggest somewhere around a 3-to-1 ratio. This is considered a moderate amount of compression. Attack and release is how fast it will react and keep the effect going as the audio crosses the threshold. I suggest not applying too much compression or it will make your audio sound off and robotic. Let's move on to equalization, known as EQ. This is an effect that can be used to make your audio sound more full and bold. It either lowers or raises the volume of the high, mid, and low end frequencies of the voice, making it sound better. Let's apply equalization to this clip. Click Effects, Filter and EQ, then select Parametric Equalizer. Most equalizers will have built-in presets like you can see here. Vocal Enhancer is a great starting out point. You can see that it boosts the low and high frequencies, creating more contrast between them and making the audio sound more full. You can adjust different points in the spectrum to make your audio sound perfect. I suggest making sure your high end is not too high, as it might make your audio a bit piercing to the ear. Now you can export your podcast and publish it. Check out our other how-to podcast videos in the description below for more information about podcasting.